So now we're going to talk about killing the symmetry. So first we had our rotisserie chicken, and we talked about a lot of symmetry. So now we're going to kill that symmetry, and we're going to show how it looks. And it's going to click with mostly open guards and, you know, everything you do in Jiu-Jitsu. So what I mean by that, why symmetry is bad, is when they're standing up. So if I'm on my back, they can go left and right like really easy, and, you know, attack me easier, like left, do some fakes and stuff, go here, I have to decide. But, and then let's say double under is there, you can go under. Yeah, I know many people are already wondering when he's going to talk about double unders. Like, let's say knee slide is there, they go knee slide, they're going to keep this away, the knee slide, and the leg is right away out. So a lot of things, let's say here, they're not easy to do, but you know, you can pull them off, and it's kind of like I have to manage both sides equally, and that makes it better for like a trickery. They can become better at this, but I can also give them a one side, like all the martial arts, like staggered stance. So what I mean by that is this. I mean this, that it's literally like I'm doing this. So me, this arm is here. I can have a butterfly guard also, symmetry. Not bad, just have to know how to deal with that. So here, and you have this section. So when you lay back, and that's what it is. So, to this side. So by giving this kind of, now it's kind of unsymmetry, kind of like a similar to leg drag position we did. So if you leg drag, we went to, you know, this position and had this. So when you have, example, knees on a mat, then, you know, this is a good guard, yeah? You have the leg on a hip, you have the shin, you're gonna have this, you have discussion about maybe it's in, maybe it's out, but this is very good. With the gi also, I like to grab, you know, thumb in or just this. This is gonna kill the position. This is kind of makes them more move, just ideas about, you know, playing guard. And also the guard I like is when they stand up, is the 2-on-1. Again, the symmetry is gone. I'm not doing this. I'm actually moving out and everything. Now, also, those sweeps are easier to do when I'm not on my back. And when I sleep, then it's easier to stand up when I'm on my side. So all the things actually become better. But you use both. So, and here, if I do this, then let's say knee slide is kind of weird to do, because here it would be easier. Just open your knee slide, push this knee, and you're gonna shove this knee away right away and knee slide. So if you have this, the feeling what it gets, the space is usually, it's weird, it's gone. And then it's, I will pummel the leg in. And also double unders, because double under kind of control is this, when I have this control. So then double under, they can't lift. So I go to right away myself, and this nice click on the elbow is here. And then I grab the head also. So this is very good, you know, elbow points and everything. This is very hard to lift. So I right away go to this position. So if double unders from here, it would be easier to go. And then I have to react. I have those canes also. And then I go like in, or I just to the end. I just turn. And everything is right away hard, and it's very, very hard to lift from here. And then I get my guard back and work from there. So having this sideways stance, if you have butterfly, and if you have, you know, this, it's very important to understand. It's not out. It's the sideways, and this knee is protecting the whole underhook space. So we're gonna talk about that position now more, let's say in a knee slide variation, double under, and also during during the spin, that because the spin has to end with that sideways stance. So we're gonna talk about that next.